உன்னை தேடி வந்தேன் சுமை தீரும் அம்மா உலகாளும் தாயே அருள் தாரும் அம்மா உலகாளும் தாயே அருள்
Good evening, friends.
Good evening, Father.
Welcome to this evening celebration. I hope you're all keeping well during this period. It's a lockdown from everything, but I hope you're eating well and having a wonderful time with your family. And above all, praying that all things might become beautiful once again in God's time. Today is another beautiful day blessed by the Lord for all of us. On this day, we are celebrating two great birthdays. Birthday of my great friend, Joe Abraham. We have walked together for nearly 50 years. We are still good friends. We never had an argument, because we understood each other well. So I pray for Joe today, asking the Lord to grant him good health of both body and mind, and keep on cheerfully serving the Lord in all that the Lord has blessed him with. And we also remember Father L.P. Raj, the previous parish priest of this church, a man who worked hard for our people, May the Lord bless him with good health because he invariably falls sick. Pray that the Lord grants him that health that he may serve the Lord cheerfully and that the Lord may accept the prayer of Lord Ju and Raj and bless all the people wherever they have been. Thus in praying for them, we have today two more little birthdays of Veronica Arikia and Stephen Santiago. May the Lord bless them too. Then today we are celebrating the feast of Mount Carmel. Let us remember our sisters at Kirky, where most of our girls go to study. God bless our sisters and bless all our children who are under their care. That this holy mass is offered in thanksgiving to Our Lady of Mount Carmel by Josephine Thomas and family. Thanksgiving in St. Jesus by Neil Jossie and family members. Thanksgiving in St. Jesus by the Sebastians, Devanason, Matthews, Alvarez, Ashwin, and our team, Lionel, Edward, Perseus, Jessica, Jennifer, and Simon. And we pray for all those who have asked us to pray for them. Then we have today the 30th death anniversary day of John Joseph, our very good friend, father. He is the brother of Father Edwin Joseph of Vianney House. He is the husband of Rani Joseph. This mass is offered by Rani Joseph and family, by Victor, Vincent, the Sebastian Singer and family, and many other families who are joining them today in thanking God for the gift of John Joseph, a beautiful person who loved God's praises to be sung always. There are many hymns which were his favorite. I'm sure the family will sing it today at home. But I pray for this man, a great man who began with the YCW many years ago as young Christian workers. Worked well at Cart Clothing and many other places. He has been blessed with a nice family and I'm sure today he is going to intercede for them and for all his close and dear friends, that we may be always pleasing to God, using all our talents to build up God's kingdom. God grant him eternal rest. And in praying for him, we also have a mass offered for Philip Anthony by Cecilia and family. And we pray for Robert, Lucas, and Marcus. Mass offered by Dorothy, Manuel and family. And as we are remembering Mount Carmel feast, this feast reminds us that in our own little Maharashtra state, we have another Mount, Mount Mary, the feast at Bandra. So many thousand throng over there to praise and thank Mother Mary. You remember Bandra feast, Mount Mary? Yes. But today we have Mount Carmel. Mount, you know what it is by now. Carmel is the name of the place where Elijah had wonderful experience of finding Israel as God's people. The Lord of hermits that were in the caves living at the time of the Great Crusades. But around the 12th century, then many hermits came together to form a community. Thus began the Carmelites. Thus began the congregation. will let this Carmel remind us that we are also to form a little family. Family to keep God with us, that God may walk with us always. But Mother Mary, she has been one with us right from the beginning. Let us turn to this Mother always. And all that this Mother has told us, if you remember, do whatever He tells you to do. She did the will of God. Are you prepared to do the will of God? Yes. Especially in these days of the big lockdown. Let us be faithful that we are responsible for the people around us. We have to be careful to see that we are not those who mingle with people easily. Keep our distance, wear our masks, because that is what is the will of God today. But we ask the Lord to remain a source of blessings to us and to our families, that we also may be radiating God's care for the other people. Today, I invite you to join with the choir that we have to sing Eternal Rest to our dear brother, John Joseph. I invite you also to sing with us. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord.
Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord. And let perpetual light shine upon him.
All together.
Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord. And let perpetual light shine upon him.
We now begin with our Eucharist. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Yes, my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge that many a time we have failed God. We have failed our families and have failed our community by not living a life that is pleasing to God. Let us call to mind our sins and purify ourselves. We confess together.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
May the venerable intercession of the glorious Virgin Mary come to our aid, we pray, O Lord, so that forfeited by our protection, we may reach the mountain which is Christ, who lives and reigns with you and in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Zechariah. Sing, rejoice, daughter of Zion, for I am coming to dwell in the middle of you. It is the Lord who speaks. Many nations will join the Lord on that day. They will become his people. But he will remain among you, and you will know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. But the Lord will hold Judah at his portion in the Holy Land, and again make Jerusalem his very own. Let all mankind be silent before the Lord, for he is awaking and is coming from his holy dwelling. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let our response be, the Almighty works marvels for me. Holy is his name. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy is his name. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. Our response, the Almighty works marvels for me. Holy is his name. He looks on his servant in her nothingness. Henceforth, all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. Our response, the Almighty works marvels for me. Holy is his name. Kindly get ready for the gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Happy are those who hear the word of God and keep it.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
Jesus was speaking to the crowds when his mother and his brother appeared. They were standing outside and were anxious to have a word with him. But to the man who told him, Jesus replied, "Who is my mother? Who are my brothers?" And stretching out his hand towards his disciples, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. Anyone who does the will of my Father in heaven, he is my brother and sister and mother." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Gospel wipe away our sins.
Amen.
Oh, say
Sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
Amen. Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you. Grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. Your death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, the gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember all those who have died in our families, John, and the many others who have died because of this virus. Have mercy on them and grant them eternal rest. We now pray for ourselves. We pray for all the peoples of the world, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and all the saints who are pleased you throughout the ages, may be merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. இவர் வழியாக இவரோடு இவரில் எல்லாம் வல்ல இறைவனாகிய தந்தையே, தூயாவினை கேட்டு எல்லாம் புகழும் மாற்றியும் என்றென்றும் உமக்கு உரியதே. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that with the help of your mercy, we may be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life.
Amen.
spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above everything, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart, as though you were already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Allow me not to be separated from you. Jesus, my good, my sweet and only love, inflame this heart of mine that it may be always on fire for you.
Let us join in singing, Eternal Rest Grant Unto Him, O Lord.
Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
We have received, O Lord, the sacrament of redemption and entreat your mercy and your compassion, that your protection for us while living may at this Eucharist grant eternal rest to our brother John, and grant him that eternal light and peace that you have promised all those who receive you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you now and forever.
Amen.
So dear friends, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Now, dear friends, I invite you to join us with the novena in honor of infant Jesus. Join us in prayer. The invocation three times.
Miraculous infant Jesus, have mercy on us. Miraculous infant Jesus, have mercy on us. Miraculous infant Jesus, have mercy on us.
Opening prayer. Dear
infant Jesus, your arms are outstretched to welcome us here, and stretched over us to bless us. Help us to spend this time in prayer, to praise you and adore you. You indeed are our Lord and Savior, with us to hear our petitions. Hear then our plea, and graciously grant our petitions. We humbly invoke your powerful aid and ask this of you, Jesus, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Novena prayer. O miraculous infant Jesus, we prostrate before your image
and beseech you to cast a merciful look on our troubled heart. Let your tender heart, so inclined to pity, be softened by our prayers, and grant us that grace for which we ardently implore you.
Now pray for your personal intention. Let us pray for all our children who are waiting for the results, that they may have a good result. Together,
Take from us all affliction and despair, all trials and misfortunes with which we are laden. For your sacred infancy's sake, hear our prayers and send us consolation and aid, that we may praise you with the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray.
Heavenly Father, You so loved us that you gave your Son as a loving and tender babe. Grant that we may labor to pattern our lives after this in the practice of childlike simplicity and love. Bless our intentions made in His name. Enable us to praise and thank you for the mercies bestowed on us through Him. We ask this in the name of infant Jesus, our Lord.
Amen. Prayer for protection against coronavirus. O God, in this time of the coronavirus, we turn to you in trust and hope. You are ever full of mercy, compassion and love towards us. We ask you, loving Father, to be merciful to us, and in your divine power, take away from all over the world this grievous pandemic of coronavirus. Inspire all authorities to take effective measures to contain the disease. Help us not to be discouraged, but to believe and hope that you will bring good out of this evil. Father, let your victory and glory shine through this deadly disease, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaids of the Lord.
Be done to them according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt amongst us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that you made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. O forth we beseech you, Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, through the incarnation of Christ thy Son, was made known by the message of an angel, and by his passion and cross, be born to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
May the divine assistance remain always with us.
And may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.
Hail Holy Queen enthroned above, Mary. Hail Mother of Mercy and of Love,
dear friends, let us join in wishing Father Joe and Raj together. All of you to sing with us.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Father Joe and Raj. Happy birthday to you. God bless you. May God bless you. Happy birthday, dear Father. Happy birthday to you. Can you have any more? Can you have any more? Happy birthday to Father, Snow, and Christ. Happy birthday to you.
So God bless you. A wonderful evening to all of you. Take care and be good to each other. And our sympathies to the Rani family. Pray for you. Thank you.